You're listening to The Deepa Kanishk Show and I am Kanishk.
And I am Deepa. Doing this interview with Amar, I think the best part for me was that he came across with such honesty and with such conviction about his failures in life, about the way he struggled through and how he grew into comedy, his first time on stage, losing his job, and all the things that we really don't find it that easy to talk about. He was so open about it, and I feel that's a very great quality which not many of us have. And more importantly, he was so frank and so open and so truthful and so honest about the entire, things in life that he faced. I didn't even realize it was good 1 hour that I spoke to him. And I feel that when you will listen to the podcast, in fact, you will also feel the same.
Here's presenting True Story with Deepa and Kanishk featuring Comedy Wala Amar.
Writing a hell lot of stuff, and when you write comedy you also have to be very careful, because in India you never know you offend who and when and how do you handle such situations?
I mean, you can't do much about it, frankly. I think comedy is the greatest expression of freedom in this world. Okay, it's the greatest expression of freedom. I mean, the one of the chapters in my book right now is called I forget the title of the chapter. But the whole idea behind this chapter is that if you want to be happy, you have to be exactly yourself, right? Now, we live in a very pretentious and sophisticated society where people are afraid of being themselves in their offices, in their homes, with their partners, just to conform and keep those relationships and those jobs. Stand-up comedy is the biggest form of self-expression, the biggest form of freedom there is. I don't want to restrain myself. I want to make jokes on my life. I want to make jokes on Shashi Tharoor, Modi, Rahul Gandhi, whatever comes to my mind. So I don't, although I try that, I don't get into jail because of comedy. because I love my life and I want to live. And I don't want somebody to pick me up and put me in the jail.
See, you've written a great story or great content. For you it's great. But when you take it out, what is more difficult? To write great content, or to actually make people understand that by putting in a lot of modulations and stuff?
So it's largely, maybe it's between writing and delivery, right? That's the question. So in terms of what I figured is, when I started doing comedy, I was not a comedian. I'm not a natural comedian, because there are natural comedians and there are not natural comedians. So I had to learn comedy. Most people felt I'll never be able to get any laughs on stage, and now I have an hour of laughs. So delivery, I've had to learn. Delivery is very difficult. Delivery is how you say one line in a joke, how you say a word in a joke, how you express the punch. Everything matters. I've seen great jokes bomb because I fucked up the punch. Sometimes I didn't say the punch in the tonality should be said with the emphasis it needs, and I've seen great jokes bomb. So delivery is extremely important. The joke has to be really good to work.
So how do you practice the delivery?
Open mics. So I mean, there's no other way to get better at comedy or get better at your jokes or perfect them besides open mics. I mean, open mics are the perfect platform where you have an audience which is open to your experimentation, and you try stuff till it becomes perfect for the show. I mean, open mics.
Okay.
Yeah.
The comedy scene is very, very popular these days, and even more demanding, I would say. So like you mentioned that you're a freelancer. I'm doing that now after 8-10 years. And so technically, I believe it requires more than just freelancing. I mean, when we say that we guys are freelancers, it's not that we are out of job. It's more like when I was in my job, or say when you were in your job, you had set number of hours and work that you would do there and come back, and that much is your life, say half a day or whatever. But when you're a freelancer, you're giving a part of yourself to your craft, isn't it? So what is more difficult, becoming a freelancer and managing more of that, or do you believe that people who are coming to comedy circuit they can still work and manage both.
Okay, there's no one clear answer to this question. Okay, like I said, there are natural comedians and there are comedians who have to work on it. Now, so it depends. It also means that there's different levels of talent, right? So somebody is more talented, somebody is less talented. Somebody who's more talented, like somebody, for example, who's been doing stage all their life, right? They could stay in the job and they could get better at comedy with the job, right? So it depends on what your perception of your talent in comedy is, how much effort you think you need. I needed a lot of effort. Like, I was bombing all through. I was bombing with my job. After I quit my job in 2015, I bombed through the year. So I needed a lot of effort to get better on stage. So I had to quit. Now I'm 38 and I'll be a comedian for the rest of my life because I put in these 4 or 5 years of effort. Although it's going to go on, but now I've got an hour of jokes, so there's confidence that I can do it.
What else do you do to, you know, keep yourself focused? Because I have met a number of people who are aspiring comics, and they will constantly tell you that my 5 minutes is not ready. Or my 30 minutes is, I'm still working. And it'll take them years, like 2 years, 3 years, they keep on doing open mic because they're not confident that they have got that 5 minutes or half an hour ready. And which is fair, that if you don't have great content, there's no point. But ultimately, some of them, you know, lose hope in their entire drill of going to open mics and performing there and still the content is not working. So there is no clear ingredient, I would say, but then still I would want to ask you this question. That when people look up to you and say that, oh, you have been there and, you know, you've got great views on YouTube and you become a big comic and everything, what can I do as an aspiring comic to be someday like you?
So first of all, I'm not a big comedian right now. So I disagree there, but cool. So, but I've been in comedy for a while to be able to answer that question. Comedy is about failure. Comedy is about failure. Now, people in society cannot take failure. I mean, most people don't pursue their dreams because they cannot take failure. Now, comedy is about accepting and absorbing failure every day. If you can't absorb failure, if you don't have the capacity to absorb failure, you can't become a comedian. Simple as that. If you don't have the capacity to absorb failure, if you don't have the capacity to go to an open mic and accept that your joke bombed, you will never become a comedian. Like, I mean, even people who are great comedians who've been doing comedy for like 10 years, although nobody's doing comedy for 10 years in India so far, because comedy started in India in 2010, and it's about 8-9 years. So even if you're doing comedy for a decade, if you write a new joke, you can never be sure that the joke will work. 100% it'll not work. Like, definitely it'll not work. If you write 5 minutes of content, I mean, maybe 1 minute will work the first time you try it. Okay, and then you try it over and over and over again to make those 5 minutes work. So it's about failure. And the point you mentioned about that you try this content in this audience, if it doesn't work, you try this content with another audience. That doesn't make sense. Because in case those 5 minutes are not working everywhere, they are not ready yet. They're not ready yet. So, I mean, if you have to say you have 5 minutes, that means they work in 10 different places. Simple as that. They work in 10 different, in front of 10 different sets of audience. So the jokes that I have, if I say I have 45 minutes of jokes, that means I've tried them over and over in different audiences. And they work all the time. So that's how it is. So comedy is about failure. I mean, if you can't digest failure, if you can't absorb failure, if you don't have the character, if you don't have the character to absorb failure, you can't do comedy. I mean, you have to be able to say, fine, I'm trying, I'm failing. That's why comedy is really time consuming, right? Because it, first of all, if you bomb, you feel like committing suicide that night. Okay, but you have to tell yourself, dude, it's okay. You have to tell yourself in your mirror, whatever you talk to, you do your pep talk, and tell yourself, dude, it happens. Talk to somebody who's been around, tell them you're feeling like shit. And they'll tell you, fine, it's okay. Because we feel like shit also. Because when we bomb, it feels like shit, right? But we have to accept that and move on. If you can't take failure, you can't do comedy. Simple.
I think it works with all the art forms, not only just comedy.
See, whatever you're doing, on stage, theater, right? The response that you expect from the audience is not laughter. People, if you're doing theater and people are listening, quietly listening, it's is there. That's all that you're expecting from them to listen. Laughter is a huge emotional response that you expect. Like, before I started doing comedy, I had done a fair bit of stage in my life. It's not that I was new to stage when I started doing comedy. But then, like, I was okay with people looking and listening to me. But then, when they didn't laugh, you know, the first time I remember I did an open mic, I always remember that. Ranish Kapoor, he was hosting an open mic in Gurgaon. I went on stage and I said whatever jokes I had written. I shivered within 3 minutes. There were about 60-70 people in the room and nobody was laughing. They were just looking at me miserably. And I shivered like hell and I left the stage within 2-3 minutes. I shivered. So comedy is difficult because it's parallel to different art forms. But again, laughter is the biggest emotional response you can get out of people. Easy to make people cry. Yes.
Okay, how does your family and friends react to your comedy and your new choice coming from a corporate world?
Yeah, so it's not easy for my family because, when I started doing all this, so I quit my job in 2015 Jan, I was 33. And in 3 months, I was 34. So I was 34 when I quit my job. At that point, I shouldn't have been quitting my job. At that point, I should have been getting married, making kids. So I'm not leading a normal life. I'm not leading a socially acceptable life, which means I'm not living my life according to society's pace. So obviously, there are problems and they don't like it that I am not leading life according to society's pace, because everybody wants people who go against society's pace, society doesn't like them. which makes sense, because if society is a person and if you're not listening to the society, including your parents, then they're not very happy about it. But as long as it depends on differing levels of not acceptance. My mom is okay as long as I'm surviving and I'm existing. My father hasn't still accepted the idea of what I'm doing. So I think, I hope he does. But it's tough. It is tough. But those decisions you take in this world, maybe they're not even 2% people who have the guts to follow their dreams. I mean, people leave it on their kids, on their next generation, to be able to follow their dreams. I didn't want to be one of them. I want to live a life where I create a life on my own terms. So yeah, it's difficult.
How does the future look like?
The future, I'm still trying to make my book work. So everybody read my book. I think eventually this book will work and a traditional publisher will get interested and I'll have a writing career because I have 4 other books written and I can write more books. So that's there. I want to inspire people with my books. I want to do more comedy because all of this needs money. All of this, to pursue your dreams, you need money. Money is fuel for life. Money is fuel. In case you don't have fuel, you run out of fuel and you stop. So I'm persisting with my dreams. If it means at some point I may need to get in a job and work with a company again to keep ensuring that I keep going with it. And and also help the company, whatever. So that's how it is. So I'm going to be a writer and comedian for the rest of my life. I mean, that's who I am. That's who Amar is. I mean, a writer and a comedian.
And that's how you know him also. You call him Comedy Wala Amar.
Comedy Wala Amar, yeah.
Okay, so I'll have a quick set of rapid fire sort of questions.
Yeah.
And you will answer, hopefully, truthfully.
Yeah.
You won't be diplomatic, promise?
Yeah.
Okay. So tell me, three best qualities about yourself which are most underrated by other people.
That's a tough question for a rapid fire. So I'm quite resilient. I can fight anything. So that's there. I have indefinite amount of patience for something I believe in. If I believe, I always say I'm not patient, but I have indefinite amount of patience. If I believe in something, my patience will not run out.
Okay. Second.
So there's patience, resilience. I don't know if that's the same thing. I'm a runner. So that's underrated. I'm a runner and I'm passionate about running and being physically active. And that's highly underrated because I think because of my running and because of my workout regime, I've been able to stay healthy and do whatever I want to do, and that's really important.
When you're not doing comedy, what are you generally interested in?
I'm reading, I'm working out, I read books.
What sort of music do you listen?
I love to dance. I mean, that's just, although I'm not a great dancer, but I love to dance. So it's just fun. So I do that. So I hang out with people sometimes. I read a lot. So when I'm alone, I've traveled solo half of the country. So my capacity to be alone is massive. I mean, my wife knows and she grudges it. But I have a huge capacity to be alone. And I would say everybody needs that. Because relationships are about interdependence. They're not about dependence. When relationships become about dependence, they suck.
Okay.
Yeah.
Who's your favorite comic?
So, Indian or what?
Indian. Give me two Indian and two Western.
So, Western is George Carlin. I mean, I don't think anybody has reached the intensity of George Carlin. I love Bill Burr also. So, Bill Burr and George Carlin. Bill Burr is alive, George Carlin is dead. And I think Bill Burr is just right in your face. He's outstanding to listen to. And George Carlin, his intensity till he was old, he was amazing to watch. I don't think anybody has reached his levels in the world so far. So Bill Burr and George Carlin.
And Indian?
Indian. So, I mean, that generally, you know, I've always been a...
Just two names.
Okay. So I like Rajneesh Kapoor, Veer Das. Yeah, took two names.
And one comic who you feel needs to work really hard.
No, I can't.
Can be yourself.
Who needs to work really hard, of course, it can be myself. And who can I say has a lot of potential? Maybe I should say. So in Delhi, there's a guy called Ashish Solanki. I love him. Ashish is insanely hilarious. And I love him as a person also. You see, I love people. If you don't like someone, you won't like the art.
Okay. Something about yourself which you would want to reveal on the show, which is not very known about.
I have a really bad temper.
That's what you want to reveal about yourself on the show.
That's horrible. Because, you know, I didn't have that bad a temper because I get angry a lot, which people don't know about me. So Jiveshu told me once, okay, Jiveshu, listen to this, okay, you told me once. This is different, but and I'm also aloof that way because I spent so much of my time, life alone, and a lot of people in the circuit believe that Amar is like, ki main topu mein logo ke saath comedy karunga, baat nahi karunga inke saath. So he's like, Jiveshu told me once, ki tu samajhta hai ki tu matlab apne sirf comedy karega, usko bhai nikal jayega. Tu hang out nahi karega, isse na, matlab you think you are a top or something. Which is not true, you know. It's just that I'm an aloof guy. I somehow, most of the time, I'm so lost within myself that I would rather just do the gig and not just like sit for small talk, which a lot of my friends, Gurinder was telling me yesterday, we were there for the show at Garage Society. He's like, tu tere saath 4 saal mein 4 baar hang out kiya maine. So basically, I don't hang out with people and because I'm just aloof.
I'll leave you on a different note.
Yeah.
Since we have spoken so much about comedy and so much about your life, the side of the poetic side of you.
Mm.
You said that you can write and you have written.
Mm.
Anything that you've written that you would want to say here? And
yeah, of course, of course. So,
so go ahead.
So I'll do a couple of them. Okay. So, so one of the chapters, as I said in my book, is about comparison, right? कि अपनी ज़िंदगी को दूसरों की ज़िंदगी से जब तक आप कंपेयर करते रहोगे तो आप खुश नहीं रह पाओगे. तो ये मैंने पोएम काफ़ी टाइम पहले लिखी थी जो मैं हर जगह सुनाता हूँ जब भी मुझसे कोई कहता है कि अपना अपना हिस्सा है अपने हिस्से की ज़िंदगी, अपना अपना हिस्सा है अपने हिस्से की ज़िंदगी, ना ढूंढ औरों के हिस्से में अपने हिस्से की ज़िंदगी. दर्द का अपना हिस्सा है खुशियों का अपना हिस्सा, दर्द का अपना हिस्सा है खुशियों का अपना हिस्सा है, अपना अपना किस्सा है अपने किस्से की ज़िंदगी, ना ढूंढ औरों के हिस्से में अपने हिस्से के.
Beautiful.
Thank you.
Beautiful, isn't it?
So there's another one I'll read, although I don't remember it exactly. So this is something I wrote when I think somewhere around when I quit my job. So life is about freedom. A massive portion of your life, of the how you become happy in life, is about how free you are to do what you want to do, right? So this is largely about freedom to be who you are, right? So pinjra tod ke ud gayi chidiya, pinjra tod ke ud gayi chidiya, dekho bhaiya ud gayi chidiya, pinjra tod ke ud gayi chidiya, wo hai mere man ki chidiya, pinjra tod ke ud gayi chidiya. पिंजरा बड़ा हो या छोटा हो, सुंदर हो या फिर खोटा हो, पिंजरा तो पिंजरा होता है ये समझाती उड़ गई चिड़िया. पिंजरा तोड़ के उड़ गई चिड़िया, पिंजरा तोड़ के उड़ गई चिड़िया, लुट जाऊंगी मर जाऊंगी पिंजरे में ना फिर आऊंगी, ये चिल्लाती उड़ गई चिड़िया, पिंजरा तोड़ के उड़ गई चिड़िया, वो है मेरे मन की चिड़िया, पिंजरा तोड़ के उड़
गई.
थैंक यू सो मच फॉर हैविंग मी. थैंक यू.